And so I mentioned specialist a couple of times. I'm back, black girl with endo. And you should know what type of specialist to go to. Top five specialists you should go to if you have endometriosis first is a specialty gynecologist. That can be a specialty urogynecologist. A urogynecologist specializes in the general pelvic area. They deal with the ureters, bladders, all of that. It can be affected by endometriosis. I highly suggest that you go to a urogynecologist. My specialist is a urogynecologist, and he can help with lots of different types of issues because his specialty is not so narrow. Second type of specialist you should go to is a gastro. A lot of people with endometriosis also have gastro issues. One of the ways that you can get some of your gastro issues relieved is to see a specialist. Now, a lot of gyno specialists know about the issues that endo can cause, but they might not necessarily have the expertise in order for you to solve them. They might just refer you to one, which is great. Lots of specialists specialize to help you live your best life. So get thee a gastro. Number three. The third type of specialist that you should have is a reproductive endocrinologist. Now, this is only if you are a person with a uterus who would like to birth children. There's lots of different ways to have children. You don't need to birth them. But if you would like to birth them and you have been diagnosed with endometriosis, please, please, please contact a reproductive endocrinologist. They will have a different view of what the uterus and the fallopian tubes and the ovaries and all of that look like and how it relates to fertility. It's different than a urogynecologist look at your reproductive system. Get thee a reproductive endocrinologist. Number four, and this is gonna seem a little bit odd, but a lot of people who have endometriosis also have mast cell issues, and mast cell issues can manifest as allergy issues. And if you are, you know, somebody who didn't really have allergies growing up and all of a sudden you have kind of weird, you know, responses, I suggest looking into an allergist, getting your allergy tests done. Especially the environmental allergies, you might just really need to be on some Flonase every day, and that might help you live your best life. Think about it. If you never went to the allergist, they never told you that you needed Flonase, and you're just walking around sad during springtime, you could have just been frolicking. Might as well go to an allergist. Get thee an allergist. Number five. This is actually the most important. I probably should have done it first. But anyway, number five is a primary care physician, PCP. Not PCP, but PCP. Don't get on them drugs. Now, you need a primary care physician because they're really your first line of defense. They can refer you to other doctors. They might have some doctors on hand that they really trust. And if you have a PCP, then you're able to trust those other doctors who they refer them to. I've had my same PCP since I was, I'm old now, but since I was like 19, my mom also goes to this PCP. And so she referred me to my reproductive endocrinologist, and that person is awesome as well. I suggest that you get a primary care physician. Get thee a primary care physician. Okay. So to recap, you need a gynecologist, a gastroenterologist, a reproductive endocrinologist, an allergist, and most importantly, a primary care physician. Please get you all of those things. If you have to choose one, please choose primary care physician. The primary care physician will help you get to the other doctor. I wish you well, and I hope you're living your best life. Run it up.